Welcome back to Logitech. Today, I'm going to review this budget CPU cooler, Jonesbo CR1000. Well, not many people know about Jonesbo brands. So I just bought this around 16 to 17 bucks only. It's very cheap for the fan with 4 heat pipe and 12 millimeter fan. Based on the spec, it has 160 watt TDP, so it should be able to handle any CPU up to 160 watt TDP. Well, let's look inside of this cooler, and after that, we will do a benchmarking for this cooler also. Okay, now let's start test it. I compare this cooler with Cooler Master H410R. I test it using Cinebench R23. The room temperature is 27 degrees Celsius. Firstly, I start test it using Core i5-11400F. Here we get the maximum temperature of Jonesbo CR1000 is 63 degrees Celsius, while the Cooler Master H410R is 67 Celsius. The score is doesn't really matter, since still between margin of error. Moving up to the next one, I use Core i7-10700. Jonesbo CR1000 temperature is at 76 degrees Celsius, while the Cooler Master is at 79 degrees Celsius. Again, score is similar. The last test is with Core i9-10900F. Jonesbo CR1000 peak at 82 degrees Celsius, while Cooler Master H410R peak at 87 degrees Celsius. Jonesbo CR1000 did a good job for cooling the Core i9-10900F with only 82 degrees Celsius. Cooler Master H410R is also acceptable, but take a note that the room temperature is 27 degrees Celsius. If your ambient is around 30 to 40 degrees Celsius, it might be reach 100 degrees Celsius with this cooler. From the test just now, this Jonesbo CR1000 is around 5 degrees cooler than this Cooler Master Hyper H410R. You can see that from the comparison of the fan and also the heatsink. The CR1000 have 12 cm fan, while the Hyper H410 has 9 cm fan. And also the heatsink inside is bigger. This CR1000 still can cool down 10900F full performance at 82 degrees Celsius with the ambient of 27 degrees. The maximum TDP withdrawal is 175 watt. So it's not a lie that this CR1000 having the maximum of 160 watt TDP. Not only from the performance, this cooler also have very beautiful white looking. The fan is white, the cooler itself is white, and it also has the RGB. If you're going to build a budget white damn PC, I really recommend you to use this Jonesboss CR1000. It can cool down your processor even you using the Core i7, of course non-K version like 10700 or 11700. If your PC ambient is around 40 degrees Celsius, I not recommend you to use this cooler for Core i9 like my Core i9 10900F, unless you limit the TDP at 150 to 160 watt. You will only lose tiny performance only in sustained load like rendering. The minus of this Jonesboss CR1000 is doesn't have the RGB sync, and the height is, yeah, this one is very high because it's using the 12 cm cooler. You really need to measure your PC case first before buying this. If not, you might not be able to close your PC later. Well, from the closing talk, I think this Jonesboss CR1000 is very good buy for only 16 to 17 bucks. It's already sufficient enough to cool down up to 160 watts CPU, and it also have very beautiful looking like this one, the white color. Okay, that's for me now. If you like this video, please press like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.